see the same thing.
Correct. Okay.
Use your hand. Move forward.
That's right.
Okay.
So you don't have videos on your iPad?
Only because in the end they have a lot of force and left over here. That has to be handled.
Camera, isn't it?
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, that is
true. What's the Wi-Fi here?
I don't
know. Right there on the board.
There it is, right there on the board.
I'm in the room.
All right, so do you need any help with anything? Or
just be happy and show up.
That's 4K. I think 4K means.
That's how much it was, yeah.
How much did you spend on it?
We were both gonna get one, and they ran out. And so he didn't get one. So he's gonna one up me. He's getting one that's like 6.5K.
No, it doesn't do 6.5K.
It doesn't do that. Although I know my buddy that has a Red Epic is buying the 6.5K one.
Really? Mm-hmm. Like, okay. Airdrop.
Oh yeah, you have to pay now.
Who's Matthew? Matthew's, oh, that's... Do you need footage? Can I air drop you some footage?
Some just footage to work with. Grandkids are great. They'll work just fine.
And then you can go show what you learned. Right?
Oh, you might need a little bit more.
Hi. How you doing?
You got a Dell over there. Are you using your iPad?
I don't know. What do you want? I brought
Yeah. We're using iMovie, so unless you have some pack on your Dell or you have it.
I use this. I was like, I just don't know. I wasn't sure what was in that one.
Do you have some video footage on there?
And what?
That I can send you some. And I'll need to make sure that you actually have the iMovie app on your iPad. Just
if you don't, it costs $4 to download it. $5.
Oh, sure. It's pretty fast. You're missing this.
Really weird.
I wonder if you have your contacts.
I wonder if you got some sort of. It's gotta be some sort of seven.
There should be an allow me to be discovered by and it should be set to everyone to want everyone to send to them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, good idea.
iMovie for iPad.
Oh, thank you.
So just one file on there, just drop it off your desktop.
Okay. Oh, you
can do it.
Yeah, if you're. Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Hey guys,
if I can
have your attention just for 2 seconds. Well, maybe a little longer than that, but I'm Corey with Velvet Home Warranty. Okay, I provide a lunch. Hope you enjoy it. There's still tons back there, so I'll have some more. I just want to share a few things about me, a few things about Elevate, if it's okay. Corey Zimmerman, I've been in real estate for 19 years. I was an escrow officer, a real estate agent, loan officer. Haven't done inspections and I haven't done appraisals yet, but I don't plan on it, so, but we'll see. Anyways, happy to be here. Thanks for letting me come. I brought a few things to kind of explain what Elevate is. Go ahead.
Thanks for that.
You bet. Yeah. And we'll do a drawing. Did everybody get a chance, by the way, to put the business card in the drawing? Do you have one?
Yeah.
If you don't, here, while I'm going, I'll write your name on one of mine. Sorry. Is that cool? Yeah, here. I just give that pin to him when he's moving. Did you get one in TJ?
No.
A couple things about Elevate real quick. We have these pass-along cards, and I just want to share. I love the laugh. One on here says, remember to laugh. My favorite, there's three jokes. I have some cards back there if you want to grab one on your way out. This joke, I'm 40 years old and I still think this joke is really funny, okay? Why can't you hear a pterodactyl going to the bathroom? The pee is silent. Mm. Huh? That's kind of funny, right? Think about it, yeah. Anyway, a couple things about Elevate Home Warranty. We're just in Utah. We are based here out of Orem, just across Geneva Road, so not too far from here. We love real estate, right? We love to elevate your business. A couple of things, a way we do that. Our plans start at 300, our basic plans 300, goes up to 500. If you have questions on the plan specifically, grab a brochure. Inside each brochure, I've also put in a plan comparison chart, so it's a little easier to read. So there's no fine print on it, it's just a little easier to read. So grab one of those, kind of explain how our plans work. We also do a welcome call to your clients. Once we get the order, we do a welcome call to your clients after it closes, after you get paid, to make sure that they understand what the home warranty is for. I think sometimes there's a little bit of misunderstanding of what it's for, and also explain to them how to file a claim. Also, if they want to change their plan within the first 30 days of the plan starting, they can do that within that first 30 days. So if they have a washer dryer that wasn't covered and they want to cover it, we can add that within that first 30 days. We have free listing coverage. Okay, that's kind of a cool thing. So it gives them basic coverage for your clients on those listings for that listing here. Okay. Another kind of cool thing that we do that's really popular is we do a red box card for your client. So every order that we get, we send your client a red box card, and here's what it looks like. It says, now that you've settled into your new home, relax and enjoy a red box movie night on us. On the flip side, it's customized to you and tailored to you. So it has your picture, your contact information, so it looks like it's coming from you. And then it says, it was a pleasure helping find your new home. You deserve a night to relax. Take this card and enjoy a free red box. And we give them a free red box code. So just another touch for your clients that you can do. Anyways, any questions on Elevate Home Warranty? No? Okay. Let's do a drawing. Is that cool?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Peter.
Local.
We are based out of Utah. We are only in Utah right now. So yeah, we're just, our office is just literally across the Geneva Road.
How long have you been?
3 years.
I use them. They do a great job.
Thank you.
I've used them for on my personal things and had claims and worked through that. And we had one problem was and they took full responsibility for it and for the rain.
You're gonna give a card, even if you don't win.
I appreciate that.
Okay, do you want to chase me on the boy up?
Sure.
But close your eyes, no cheating.
I'll do the honors.
Okay.
Steve Robbins.
I didn't even got the right side.
Yeah, I know. That's
why. $25 gift card, Olive Garden. So pasta now and pasta tonight.
Sweet, thank you.
All right.
Appreciate that.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, grab a chapstick on your way up too. There's a chapstick back there.
Thanks again. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Everybody have video footage on your iPad or. That'll probably take.
Oh, I wouldn't do it.
Yeah, that'll probably take you.
I didn't.
You bought the app, but you can't install it because your iOS is outdated.
Right.
Here, I'll give you my iPad.
I'm sorry.
You can use my iPad. I think I'm gonna pass. I usually wait till the second generation of things just to let them get all the kinks worked out.
You're on the watch?
The iPad Pro. Oh,
yeah. This is amazing. You can just look at the first gen and the second gen. So I'm going to get the second watch.
I like the first one. I think it's like magic when you go to stores and buy stuff that you don't miss.
Okay, so in order to edit a video, you got to have some video to edit. And that's why I've given you all footage. Or if you have, even if you have random footage of your kids playing on that you're recording from your phone, you can use that too or whatever. It's all going to be the same. Just depends. This is a real estate class, and a little introduction about myself. I'm a realtor. Been a realtor for 11 years now, and I'm also a videographer. And I started doing video, just doing family stuff with my own kids. I would piece things together, and people liked what I was doing, and so I decided, maybe I should make this hobby a little business. So I started doing weddings. I've done birth stories, funerals, and then I was like, well, I do real estate, I might as well merge the two. And so I started doing video tours for my clients where I would put a camera on a glide cam and I would walk through the house and then piece the video together with music and titles and that kind of stuff. But I liked it because it provided a better feel of how the floor plan flowed. Whereas if you're looking at a static image, it leaves your imagination like, well, where does that door go in relation to this room, and how does this floor plan work? Whereas when you walk through with the video camera, you actually got the feel how it all went. Not only that, but music gives you an emotional tie to the video that you're watching. You can watch a movie without music, and then a movie with music, and it'll totally pull at your emotions differently than if it doesn't have music. So the choice in music that you use will determine the mood that the video has and your emotions and that kind of thing. So that's why I like video over pictures. Pictures have their place for sure, but I like video. So the first step is to get your footage into iMovie. Everybody have iMovie open?
Almost
okay. You got footage that you're using?
Yeah. And
This is Drew. What is your title? The head of the tech committee?
I'm the chair. Committee chair this year. For
committee chair.
Month and a half.
Yeah. So thanks to Drew for
being awesome.
Awesome does, yeah.
Giving me lots of Facebook fodder.
I'll help and jump in a little bit with Jason on this. I've been using iMovie since Macs were light blue, right? And back then heck, I've been selling real estate for 4 or 5 years at that point, and I hacked iMovie together to make a listing presentation that was a video that I distributed all the way back then. It was called 10 Reasons to List with Matthew Group. So it was a, it's very powerful for what it is. It's a little tiny thing. We're gonna have Jason just teach us this to begin with, based on the computer version. The iPad version is so similar to it, and if you need more capability, you can spend $300 and you can move up. And that's what Jason and I generally use at this point, is the next version of this, which is Final Cut Pro 10. So, Final Cut Pro. But don't even worry about that. That's for Mac, and that's for when you get to the point where you're like, you know what, I've outgrown the capabilities of iMovie. Then you move up into that. And for both of us, if we stutter in trying to figure this stuff out, it's because while all the controls are really, really similar and the layout's really, really similar, sometimes we may be looking for a feature that we're really used to it being there that's not in the iMovie version. So,
yeah, all the versions are different. The nice thing is, if you do have the latest version, the Apple ecosystem, they try to make everything coherent so that you have the same symbols. Like this little symbol right here, that's a share symbol. This little symbol right here, import. This is to add stuff. So they try to keep their symbols the same across them, all of their platforms. So first of all, you need to get your movie from your device or wherever you have it into iMovie, and that is called importing. So you're going to import your media, and that's a little arrow. So some of you have older versions. If you go to File, there's always a whole bunch of different ways you can do the same thing. So File and Import Media, or you can click the down arrow for Import Media. And then you're going to have to navigate to where your media is. So I told everyone with the thumb drive to go to your desktop and put your file on the desktop. So if you go to desktop, if I'm going too fast, just tell me to slow down, or if you have questions, raise your hand and stop me in the middle of what I'm saying. We can get there. So you're going to navigate to the file. It was called Tech Thursday Stock Files. And I've got video, sound, audio, and pictures there that you're going to import. So if you select one, you'll see it highlighted in blue. Yep. Anybody there? Everybody have their files up?
No, you're ahead.
So close this.
Cancel.
And then go. Okay. Actually,
it's almost there.
Well, that's media.
Oh, it's about a gigabyte. Oh.
At the top, there's a.
Did you say you click on the import media?
Yeah. You want to import media.
The projects are here.
And you'll be able to name your project too at this point, or your event.
It's going to take too long to download or something.
Oh, gotcha.
They're still importing.
So you're importing it there. Okay. It'll look a little different on yours. So yeah, once. What's that?
When you're looking at the iOS version, it requires you to choose a theme. You can unapply the theme elements, but it requires you to start out by choosing a theme. So this is what we've got. So now, like this, and so that's just like a photo or video that you're going to add. So you go over here and you can say, what do I want? You can say the Washington DC trip. So something like that. What it does is it's important. It's going to set that to be here.
So once you have the one highlighted, if you hold the shift key, shift always lets you select multiple items. So if you have the top one highlighted, you hold the shift key and you select the bottom one, then it'll select all of that media that you've got there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow. Once you've done that, you click import selected, and it will import all of your media into iMovie. So let's get everybody caught up there. Everybody, anybody not have their media in iMovie?
Yeah. Yeah.
Not ours.
Still. Behind yours?
Yep. This is a listing I have in Salem that I actually just put under contract yesterday. So fortunately, it's not there. Okay, so when you're at this screen, you can review all of your footage. And this is what's in call a library. So all of your footage, the main footage, will be organized in the library on the left. And then you can review it there in the middle. And once again, there's a million different ways that you can go about doing this. Some video editors like to do things one way, some will like to do things others. My preference is to go through this library stuff and select which footage I want to use here before doing anything else. So take notes on these. These are if you have the latest version of iMovie, the space bar will play. So if I click the space bar, it plays the movie. The I button sets an in point. So when I click I, you'll see that there's a yellow box there. That's where it starts. So an in point is start, and O sets an out point. So as long if it's playing and I want the footage from this point, I'm going to push I and set an in point, space bar until I want to stop. And I'll say, that looks good. Out, and then the O sets an out point. And then F is to favorite. And then you'll see that little green bar, and that'll help you organize your clips. So another way to do it is to go over, they call this scrubbing. When you're going across your footage, you're scrubbing across, and you can just grab it. So if you just click and drag with your mouse,
that's the way I do it.
That's the way you do it?
Scrub and grab, and then I just drop them all into the timeline and juggle the timeline. So.
Yeah, the reason I do like using the hotkeys is because you can actually use the arrows. So if you use the arrow forward and back, you can get really incremental as far as which frame you want to end at.
So with the iPad, you need the keyboard or?
No, just choose your finger.
Yeah.
So we imported the whole clip right there. So we can take that clip back down like this.
I'll walk around for a minute and see how it is doing.
Down here, still back up here. Then you go like this, and then just take that off.
Okay, so here, space bar. Starts it, or you can use your mouse like Drew says he likes to use his mouse. Yeah, just click, right click, and drag.
And I apologize because I put together.
You can stop it where you want.
I have a whole bunch of clips from a house that I recently did. It's an awesome house for doing this. It's like a $2 million house.
And it'll start. And
but
then
I did
the space
those
bar
clips
is
on my
button.
Canon 7D, and I did them in a format that the iPad doesn't like.
So now hit the space bar.
And so I imported it all.
And then hit O.
It says
and
we don't like your format now. On my computer,
and then
it works fine. But on
favorite.
The iPad,
if that's
like
the clip
it.
You
so,
want to use,
so I
F
was going to show you a bunch of those. But with that,
yeah.
I, like
Command Z
like I
is
say,
your unmute function.
Your
so if you want to just start over,
the best way to shoot a house.
So you can choose your clip.
Is not just walking through it.
particularly
by selecting here,
without something to steady your camera.
So what is that?
With your finger? Or
there's all kinds of them. You can buy from a company called Fiu. You can F-E-I-Y-E. You can buy a gimbal.
Just that much.
You have a handle, and your iPhone sits on it. And as you walk, it takes all the movement out. The company is called F-E-Y-I-U, I think. Fiu. It's a Japanese. It's for, it'll hold your phone, I have one for my GoPro.
That's great, it's a project.
At this project, we both have drones, and DJI has one that's for, it's
that's the last thing I should probably
it's a separate camera that's on a table like that, that's awesome. But, because you don't have one of those, you don't need one for taking videos
that you can use
of houses. What
so
you do
you don't
is you take little tiny panoramas.
No theme, but this
right.
Just makes
so
it really easy.
If I
it does all the transitions for you.
Like this.
So if you like to look at that, you select that theme.
In
you say create.
And I stop, and I go 4 second clip.
Now.
And then I come over to another angle
you add your,
or another room.
So.
And I do the same thing. Now I go from a different angle, and I just hold it real still. And do a 4 second clip here. Right? And then I go in the bathroom.
Okay, so
if you know, you've got a big fireplace, you just take a clip and you just go
now,
like that. You walk the fireplace like this.
Now
and then you use each of those clips as a still, so it's almost like a slideshow.
And then once you have it,
that's the best way to do it when you don't have something
right
to steady your, like a glide cam or something. We've had several different ones like that. I like the ones that are powered now, where you've got a gimbal that takes all the movement out of it instead.
Out,
you can do that with the software.
What you want.
Not on your iPad. Right? Maybe not
this,
on your iPad.
They don't,
but on iMovie, there's actually
like
they take the shape out of it. But what
simpler.
It does is it crops,
so I would just
it looks for the main focal point
of
the picture, and it crops off the edges so the edges don't move like this because it's taken and moved what it's showing on the screen. So
how do you do it?
Jolt this way, then it compensates and slides the picture that's showing
you,
this way, and you lose a lot.
You did get your video
you lose a lot
in there.
And,
nice.
And
so you just can't use the
hotkeys
on this. You have to use your mouse, and then you have a green star.
To show enough
the red X will make it not a favorite, and that unmarks it. So
but
the red X actually is
I could do our
killer you don't want.
Video
I usually don't even do that. Unless it's a full clip that I don't want.
Your iPad works great.
Mm-hmm. And yep. Then instead of that, you'll take your favorites and you can drop it up there into a new project. And you'll have to create a new project for that.
I can. I like that better.
Question.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, but I, yeah, you can do it with your iPhone. The new iPhones, the ones that just came out, will do shoot 4K video. Super high resolution. So they have a little tiny sensor, and so the dynamic range isn't as good as something like this that has a Micro Four Thirds sensor. It's big. So there's some real advantages to having better equipment, but what you've got on your phone is light years ahead of. I mean, Matthew and I. In 2002, bought a Canon GL2 that the first iPhone, it cost us $3,000, maybe $3,500 for that camera. And the first iPhone that came out had one a camera in it that was as good as that one. So that you can do everything with your phone. The one thing you don't have is you don't have the glass, but that's the thing that's so nice about this versus stills is you know, I mean, you get
a
little tiny bathroom, and unless you've got, we've got these chunks of glass that's, you know, I mean, for the DSLR, the right lens to make that little space so you can see the whole thing without warping it all into weird things cost $1,000 minimum. And so if you use iMovie instead, that's why you're here, and you do these little pans. Then you can show the whole thing without having to fit it all in one frame initially.
And then
you know what I mean?
To get into the tour, not into the phone.
No. It's the best thing you do is see all of those on your iPad, all those apps are all connected. So Photos is where it'll store it. So you take it with camera, then you store it in Photos, and then you import it into iMovie. And they all look at the same place.
Into the MLS? The MLS, what, is it a tour? It's not
a... The problem with the MLS is the MLS doesn't allow us to use YouTube, right? And so that is a problem, is that a lot of the tour providers that are out there will allow you to shoot your own tour and then to upload it through theirs, but the WFR only allows about 50 different tour providers, but you have to have some sort of an arrangement with OVO or with somebody there. OVO has one, it's about $20 a month that they'll let you just use their software, and they become the tour provider, and you load it full of the pictures, and you load it full of everything, and a lot of the other ones will do that as well. I love YouTube. It works great, but the problem is that they won't let us link directly off of there. So what I've done a lot of times is I'll put in the remarks, there's a killer YouTube video that's 2 minutes long, you know, that you can see, just, you know, text me for the link or whatever, and then the agent, while he's there or whatever, will do that sometimes. But these kind of things I'm using more for, I mean, more and more when people are in front of the house, they're texting you or calling you, and I just say, hey, let me send you a link back to that. And then I send them the link to the video. At some point, I could show them the one that I did for that Alpine house that you saw. It was pretty killer. So that's the clips that I was hoping to show here. But we'll do that towards the end. Let's keep working on getting some knowledge out of Jason's brain.
Just the reason that they at WFR won't let you use YouTube videos is because there are ads. So because I'm registered as a tour vendor, and I can use Vimeo, which is another social networking video
site, to host the video.
Yeah, because Vimeo you actually have to pay for. I have to pay for the subscription, and there's no ads. But they don't want you pulling up a YouTube ad as a realtor and sending it to your client, and then all of a sudden have Drew's face show up. Hey, let's go call Drew. So it's kind of to protect the integrity of the agents and that kind of thing. But yeah, I actually like YouTube better because it does cocaine.
I think Vimeo does too.
They're rolling it out, but it's like slow, and you have to, I don't know, it's not as easy.
YouTube's pretty incredible. I mean, the new streaming from YouTube, I just bought it, the TerraDeck.
Oh, nice.
The TerraDeck Pro, actually, for this. So keep going.
Okay, so did everybody favorite some clips? You've got green stuff in there? No? Favorite? On the iPad, you won't have a favorite clip.
On the iPad, you just drag it down to your timeline.
Yeah, just drag what you want.
Now, once you've dragged it down, one of the things that you can see is if you look up at the top, you see how it has orange now at the top? That means that it's on your timeline. Instead of just favorited, that means that it's on your timeline, so you can tell what's being used and what's not out of your inventory of clips.
Correct.
So.
So once you've got some clips favorited, let me favorite a few more here. So I for the in, O for the out. I want the mount shots. Oh, and if you click those multiple times, so here's a couple other keys that might confuse you, but J is to go backwards, L is to go forwards, and if you push them multiple times, it'll go faster and slower. Like, see how quick I'm zooming through the video. So that's why I like these hotkeys, because it really speeds up the process. So I set an in point, and I like those mountains, out point, favorite, and F. And that allows you to organize your media. So up here you see this hide rejected. If you actually, let's say there's a shot that I don't like this one, hovers right around the front of the house too long, I don't want that. I'm gonna go in point, out point, and then I'm gonna hit delete, and it's gonna take it out. And then it hides, that's because I have hide rejected. If I have all clips here, then you'll see that it'll show the full clip with red there, because I don't wanna use that, but that's my favorite. So the way that I like to work with my workflow is favorite all my stuff first, and then I go up here to favorites, so that all I see are the clips that I wanna use. and then I'm not confused by all of the other stuff. So once you've done that, you actually do have to create a project. And Steve, you've already done this. So if you go to projects, and on your iPads, some of you have already done this too, because if you're dropping it into your timeline, you've already got a project. You're gonna go new movie, and you can choose some themes, and iMovie does a really good job of making it super simple for you. So if you want to not worry about anything as far as transitions go, and transitions are what you do between clips, fades, you can do different things. But this, if you choose a theme, it will automatically add transitions for you. It'll pick music for you, and it'll add these little title things. So for our sake, I'm going to say no theme.
Now here's the thing.
Go ahead.
With the iPad version, no theme is not an option.
Oh, really?
You have to use a theme. They force you to. Now, you can turn off the elements that it adds because it pre-picks some background music and it pre-picks some transitions between clips and some titling. But you can turn that off later, but you can do it without choosing a theme. So I always just use Bright or something.
Gotcha. Maybe since you guys are all on iPads, I'll just, I'm going to go with nothing. Just because it'll give it. So then I usually call it like my property address. Just because it keeps it easy. And then you've got your timeline down here. This is called your timeline. That's where you're going to organize all of the clips from your library that you favorited. So if you click over here on iMovie Library, you should see the stuff that you imported. It might have a date if you haven't named it. It might have today's date or something like that. And it'll show up there in the library. So I still have all my clips here. Okay, so now you can start dragging and dropping. And I've got on your stuff, I gave you some photos, so you can also throw in some photos, because photos are, a lot of times you'll see the slideshows. If you click on your favorite, it'll highlight the green part, and then you can drag and drop that down. You can also continue to edit here and do your whole favorites thing here. Or you don't even have to favorite it if you don't want. If you just want to grab a piece of something and take it, then you can do that as well. And you'll just start dragging them into your timeline and drop them in. So once you've got some videos in your timeline, maybe throw a picture in there too, just for the fun of it. And it'll tell you the length of your clip right here, 5 seconds. And what was your name?
George.
George and
Simon.
Simon. Simon was asking me if there's like a rule for how long you want your clip to be so that people don't get bored. Because sometimes you'll be watching a movie and your brain moves faster than the movie and your eyes, and it all plays into it. And so I generally try to keep my clips to about 4 or 6 seconds, unless there's something that needs...
Something cool.
Yeah, something that needs to be... Like aerial shots usually are longer because it's cool.
well, there's so much more that it... With the aerial, but you can't do... Like if you're doing a video, the aerial shot portion of it is going to be 20 seconds out of a minute and a half total length video, or a minute video. And the reason the aerial shot is a little longer is because it's moving and it's taking so much more in. There's a lot to see within the shot. And so people can sit and focus. I mean, I like to do orbits. So you do an orbit around the house, and now they're looking at the backyard. Now they're looking at the front yard. Another thing that might help you think about this a little bit is this, the white line right here is your playhead. That's what that's called. Now, some of us are a little older, and if you think of this as in, this is a piece of analog tape, right? So this is your playhead, which is touching the tape and giving you what is underneath it, the tape. And so when we talk about splices and transitions,
if you think of that like you're working with a piece of tape, that sometimes makes it a little bit easier.
Yeah.
What are the other shortcut keys you use? J.
I, J, L, and the space bar are kind of my go. Oh, I, O, J, L, and the space bar.
What's J again?
J goes backwards. L moves forwards, and if you push multiple times, it'll speed up. And you can use those same keys in the timeline. So like right here, I'm pushing J and L, and K stops it, but I don't really, I usually use the space bar instead of K. But yeah, and your I, your in and out points will still work here as well on the timeline. So it really speeds up your workflow if you do get those things down. But you can also use your mouse to do the same stuff. Okay, so this right here would be a transition. Right now, you can see when it transitions to the inside, there it just jumps. There's nothing there. So there is no transition really. If you want to do a transition, if you look at the top, you'll have a full thing of transitions that you can do where you can add, you just click and drag between the two clips that you want to add it to. Did you see that? Click and drag, and then all of a sudden, you've got a transition. If it's on top, everything that's on top is always going to be in the front, basically. So yeah, depending on how you layer it, if you wanted to put it down in that section, then yeah, if you lay it over it, then that's what's going to be on top.
Yes, and with video, what you're doing with that, it's just pulling the water out of here. There's a way you can make these faster or slower. So that should speed in here right there. So I double click the video.
Yeah, you have to crop the video in order to see.
Show speed in
here. It's just going to cut and do that right there. Because it shows whatever's on top. But if you did crop that, then this will appear on the outside of the crop. So you could technically, you could do that, or make it so this is half screen and put that, but then it's going to distort it because it's designed for 16:9 screen.
It's slow, but that's how you do that. You speed it up and slow it down.
Can't you just send the iMovie to a client?
Says, what do you mean?
You know, like if I took the pictures and uploaded them, and
you don't have to do it that way.
Oh yeah, totally. That's what Drew was saying he does.
That's all I want.
Yeah, and you can actually, if you upload it to YouTube, you can get a QR code
is
that's printed.
To upload it to YouTube for that?
From iMovie on the iPad or on your phone, if you set up your YouTube login and stuff, like for your Google account, you can export directly to YouTube once you're done with the project.
And then you have a separate QR code for every single one, just for that.
No, I would have a separate one for every
house.
I would do a separate one for each floor plan.
You showing them how to speed ramp? Do the retiming?
Yeah.
Nice.
And it hit a right click, and that's what happens. Getting to a whole new product.
I'm not seeing it pop up here. Assignment.
That's just if I'm on the Wi-Fi.
You do need to be on the same Wi-Fi.
Yeah, I'm on that
you
one.
You are? Should.
He's up.
Okay.
I just barely switched it to everyone, so my text has got a second.
Okay, so everybody plays with some transitions. Let's do. Peterson, is that you?
Place.
So
no.
What do? I just select whatever.
Okay. Yeah. And so you just change you can grab the handle at the beginning or the end.
Okay.
And change the size of what you're pulling onto your timeline. Now, I would close your theme thing because that's a pain in the butt.
Okay.
It's taking up a
lot of space. So if you click on audio, you have a few different things. We imported media. So you already have the songs. And a word of advice on music. There are copyright laws.
Oh, I see. You're looking
at selling real estate and you're making money off of someone else's video,
technically, I clip inventory.
And
then use that as a screen. So,
record your own music. The songs that I gave you, I actually downloaded from a place called YouTube Audio Library.
If you have a nice long linear,
so
I close this and
you can add
this
to your audio library. You have to sign in with a Gmail account. But if you have a Gmail account and you sign in, you Google, YouTube audio library, it will send you to a place on YouTube where you can download a whole bunch of different free music and use it without worrying about anything. So those songs that I gave you are, they are no copyright. Anyone can use those songs for whatever purpose they want. You can make money with those songs. They're just free YouTube songs. And there are actually some good stuff out there. Like these ones that I selected aren't too bad. So once again, when you're picking your music, it's all about the mood. You can hear kind of like, listen to the beats. And I'll show you in a minute, but this is actually the song that I did use for this movie that I completed. Because it kind of, there's a swamp, like a wetland. It's kind of sounds swampy.
So for a little Louisiana.
Yeah. So go ahead and just choose a song. You don't have to select a certain length. You can actually just take the whole song if you want and drop it in. And then you can move it with your mouse. And you can select different portions of the song by grabbing and pulling it if you wanted a different part of the song.
It's all good.
Jason, do you have any footage where, see, with a drone, the drones don't have microphones on the cameras at all. And so one of the things that we ought to show you is how you can split the audio portion off of the video clip, because when you're shooting with your phone and you're shooting these little clips, you're going to get your hand, the sound of your hand brushing the microphone and different things like that. So you can split that off, or you can mute it directly on the clip still, so that your music, you can hear your music, and you're not hearing your audio from your microphone on your camera.
Trial and error, is that how you learn?
And Google.
Yeah. And Google, yeah. I know that I have any other videos on here that have. But we could actually probably just show them with this thing. So, do you see how there's a little line right here in the middle of the green? That's the volume line. If you click and drag up and down, you can adjust the volume of the whole track. And what Drew's saying is usually that same line will be up here in this little blue area. The same line, and you can pick and you can click and drag it. If you select a certain portion of it, so let's say I just want this audio muted, you can select and drag and then click and it'll only mute and raise that portion that you've selected and dragged. Command Z will once again reset it. So here, I'll show you. So yeah, if there's someone talking in the background and you want to be able to hear them, or if, like Drew said, there's something you don't want to hear, then you just move that. And you can, once you've moved it, you can actually adjust it with these little, what do they call these things?
Handles.
Keystroke handles. Right here. So yeah, and you can make it fade. So the longer this one, the further this one is away from this one, the longer the fade will be. And then you'll see it'll fade back in real quick because it's closer. There's also these little handles in the front and backs of all of the audio tracks that you can adjust to fade in and fade out the audio. And those would all be up here too if I had audio on these clips. I should have.
Yeah, what ends up happening is up by the settings, if there's audio in the clip, there's actually a waveform that'll show up there. And then you can see where the blue
is where the audio will be along the bottom of the pictures for each of these clips. And you right click, like if you guys have some of this in here that has audio, you can right click on it on your computer and it'll have a drop down menu, and one of them is it allows you to detach the audio. See that one right there? And so, like, if you want to do a voiceover, you can click on your phone and take a video of you, but you can, you know, taking a video of your desk, and you can do a voiceover, pull it in, and then split it off, and you don't need a separate recording application or something like that to do that. So if you say detach the audio, then if it's attached to the clip, then it's right in here. When you say detach the audio, then it drops it down here. And you got to be careful with doing that if you're doing grandkids. If you're doing houses, it's one thing. If you're doing grandkids, then you could get their talking and stuff out of sync with the video.
Their mouths won't be moving. So, yeah. Sorry, I should have done that. Okay, so that's a little bit with audio. One of my favorite things to do, and this is like this is what makes your video... It really makes your video good is to actually snap the beats to your transitions. So you can see that this song has a beat right there, and there. If you take this little handle and you drag it over so that it's at the beat, then when it the video actually changes with the beat, and it's way more fun to watch and more entertaining. So I would totally, it takes more time, it's a little tedious sometimes, but you can do that. And one thing that you can do is you can listen to the whole song, and if you use the M key, it makes a mark. So if you go through the whole song and you listen to the beat, like that, then when you drag your clip over, it will just put it right on that little beat marker, so that you, that one's not for me.
It's because the transition space.
And sometimes it'll be a little off. That's where it gets really tedious if you're like, man, what's that? Click titles, keep crashing.
That's really weird. He doesn't usually use iMovie, so
you have to have an Apple computer to do this. You can't do it on a.
No, you get to work with Windows Movie Editor or something. It's really stupid. iMovie is super powerful, and on a Mac, it's free now. Comes with it, so, and $5 for your iPad, so.
We don't have those controls on the iPad. Like,
no, you use your finger. If you had a keyboard, a Bluetooth keyboard for it, I bet it would work.
Oh, I have a keyboard. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
This project, this is the one that's going to be.
The truth is that iMovie and the other apps, but really probably iMovie probably had 10 or 20% of the credit for Apple's resurgence when iMac came out. It saved them. It's one of the big things.
Here's another handy note-taking thing. If you push Command Plus and Command Minus, it'll zoom in and zoom out of your both your events, your library, as well as your timeline. So if I push Command minus, see how all my clips get compressed down. Or if I want, I push Command plus and I can get really close. And so if you want to edit more in detail, Command plus and Command minus.
I slide something, I just use a little slider.
Oh yeah, that works too. It's just a little slow. So yeah, titles. There's a thing called titles. If you click on titles, it'll open up a whole bunch of titles. And for some reason, I keep crashing.
Why don't you just open it up in Minecraft?
It's weird.
It looks almost the same. Matter of fact, if you ever move up to Final Cut and you think you need that extra power, all of the files open in Final Cut that you made in iMovie. So it's a real seamless transition. But they use this to actually make movies.
What's the cost of that?
About $300.
Far cry from $1,000.
Actually get to the point where you can do some really incredibly powerful things in Final Cut with aftermarket plugins and third-party additions and all kinds of stuff that's amazing.
I think it might be this questions this far? Okay, so anybody make it to titles and start playing around with some titles.
Can you do titles on this?
Yeah, you should.
Yeah.
There's not as many, but once you go there, you can actually preview the titles just by scrubbing over them, and you'll see what it looks like.
And how do you get to titles?
It should be a little box. It has a T.
Hit on the strip on the bottom, and I'll give it a T on the left.
Top is what you're seeing first.
Exactly. So if I did one of these titles up here, that's a full thing, and I put it over there, and all it's going to show, oh, never mind, these ones aren't full. If you did a background, for example, these backgrounds, these are globes and stuff. If you drag one of these down and you put it on top,
choose a different one. Because it's creating the world map.
And we'll do a stop. So if that's on top, so there you, I still have a title that's in the top there.
And yeah, your can title, you have more than one title?
Yes.
Yeah, you can overlay them on here. I don't know that you can actually manipulate where they go. In Final Cut Pro, you can actually move the title around.
It only gives you a center or lower.
Okay, gotcha.
Right there.
Drag the bar back on that so that it only shows the title for like 2 seconds.
Yeah. Yep.
You guys see if you go back and it clicks on that, you see up here where it gives you the. Well, you got to click on your title. That's that. So now you can change the font, you can change the size, you can change which side it's defaulted, you know, set to.
Yeah. All those things.
With Final Cut Pro, you can drag the title anywhere you want and make it so it sits down in the corner and it's this big, or you can overlay your company logo or whatever you want.
Okay, I should probably show you the Ken Burns thing too, because that's pretty key. With your video and with photos, you can crop certain things. So So let's say, for example, let's use this one, this image, video. I got a lot of sky in that shot, and maybe I don't want that much sky. Or actually, let's get rid of the roof. The sky looks better than that half of the roof there. So if I select the clip, I can go to this little symbol. This is the crop symbol. And if you click that, you can fit, means it's going to fit the whole thing to the screen. Crop to fill will give you these the options to then grab the edge and move it up. And then it'll crop to only what's highlighted there. It crops out the gray stuff.
Now you could grab that whole thing, you could slide that back over here, or pull
right.
down, or whatever you want.
Move around. So let's say I want right there, and then this little checkbox confirms what you're doing. Now the roof's out of the shot, and I just have the neighborhood of the sky. And it's probably a little advanced to get into all this, but there's a lot of really fun functions. Like, these are color correction things. You can take the saturation, and you can take the color out completely, or bump it up and make it brighter. You can, this is the saturation one. So you can play with the color that way. There's all of these little presets. This is a auto color function. Where are those?
There's also the speed, if you wanted to speed up that pan.
Oh yeah.
You could right click on the
See, this is the other one too. See that right there where it says stabilize shaky.